So now let's look at branch prediction accuracy and how it affects performance. Our CPI can be written as 1, which is the CPI we get with ideal pipelining, plus the cycles we add on average per instruction because of branch mispredictions. And that can be written as how often we have mispredictions times the penalty we pay in terms of cycles every time we have a misprediction. Note that this part is determined by predictor accuracy. It really says how often do we mispredict. This part is determined by our pipeline, where in the pipeline we figure out that we have mispredicted. That's approximately how many cycles we pay. Let's look at a more specific example. Let's look at a processor that resolves branches in its third stage of the pipeline, and at a processor that resolves branches in its 10th stage of a pipeline. This is actually much closer to what modern processors do. Let's also look at different accuracies for predictors. We will look at a predictor that is 50% accurate for branches and 100% accurate for all other instructions. And we will look at a predictor that is 90% accurate for branches and 100% accurate for all other instructions. And in all of this, we will be assuming that about 20% of all instructions are branches. This is pretty common in programs. Now, let's compute our CPIs. Here we have a CPI of 1 plus how many mispredictions do we get per instruction? We get 50% misprediction for branches, so we get 0.5 of branches are mispredicted, but branches are only 0.2 of all instructions. So these two really are the mispredictions per instruction. It's really the mispredictions per branch times branches per instruction. And this is multiplied by the penalty that we get per misprediction. If we resolve branches in the third stage, at that time, we have two stages of the pipeline where wrong stuff is already fetched. So the penalty will be two cycles. Note that if we resolve the branch in the first stage, then there would be no penalty because next cycle we can fetch the correct instruction. So branches being resolved in some stage means really that we pay one cycle less than that in penalties. And we get an overall CPI of 1.2 here. If we resolve the branches in the 10th stage, this part is the same, the accuracy of the predictor and the frequency of branches, but the penalty now would be 9 cycles. So we have 1 plus 0.5 times 0.2 times 9 in this case, for the overall CPI of 1.9. This is a significantly worse CPI than we were getting here. Now let's look at the more accurate branch prediction. Now what we have is 1 plus mispredictions per instruction are going to be how many mispredictions we have per branch. We are 90% accurate, that means we are 10% misprediction, times 0.2, because not all instructions are branches, times 2, which is our penalty. And we end up with 1.04. So this is a significant improvement from a more accurate predictor. Let's look now at this processor. Here we have 1 plus 0.1 times 0.2 times now 9. And when we compute this, we get 1.18. What we can conclude from this is that a better branch predictor will help us regardless of whether we have a shallow or a deep pipeline, but the amount of help from a better predictor changes depending on how deep the pipeline is. Here we have a speed up of 1.15 when we go from worse to better predictor in our shallow pipeline, but here we have a speed up of 1.61 when we go from the same worst predictor to the same better predictor in a deeper pipeline. As you can see, the deeper the pipeline, the more dependent it is on having a good predictor for good performance. And that is really why research in branch predictors continues to this day. Although our predictors are now pretty good, they're significantly better than 90% accurate for branches, However, our pipelines are deep, so we still benefit from further improvements.